you very much, and welcome to this, our final performance experience at Texas Tech University, our Department of Orchestral Studies. I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we're going to play for you today, a little bit of what you're going to see. Now, for those of you who have come to some of our other performances, in fact, since I'm the only one on stage, I'll make it easier for you to hear me now. You'll notice that the orchestras are in a different configuration this semester. Due to COVID policies and protocols, we have separated and segmented out smaller ensembles from all of our larger groups. So our symphony orchestra became two or three groups. Ensemble Bravura became two groups. This has provided an incredible opportunity for us to spend some time in some gems of repertoire that aren't normally, we don't normally get a chance to spend that much time in, and it's been a wonderful opportunity. And that's what I wanted to kind of draw to your attention, is that our mantra at Texas Tech for the last 16 months or so has been to find opportunities in our collective challenges, specifically in the separation and isolation that we feel as musicians and all of us feel in our own lives, in that the more difficult challenges of connecting with each other. We've used this as an opportunity to connect in a very intimate, powerful way, all with the intention, as always, as allowing our musicians to individually grow as musicians and artists at every moment. What you're going to hear first on the program is two very, very different things. Two different ensembles are going to take the stage in a few minutes. The first will be USO, the University Symphony Orchestra, Green Group, to play two tangos. Now, you might notice immediately there won't be a conductor. And the reason for this is USO actually did a very classical kind of wheelhouse canon type program of Orensky and Tchaikovsky earlier in the semester, and they've also done a recorded performance of Kurt Weill's Street Scene. So we found an opportunity in their challenge of having a few weeks free to bring one of Texas Tech's finest, Charles Olivier, the director of our tango orchestra, in for a collaboration where he was able to work with our ensembles about learning tango techniques, performance practices, style. I have to say it was tremendously, it was of amazing value. I think I learned even more than the students did. And in just a moment, you're gonna hear USO Green come out and perform conductorless two different tangos. One, a contemporary style tango called Sur, and the second, Linea di Tiempo, a classical kind of older style tango that was arranged by Charles Olivier himself. So without any further ado, I'm gonna ask USO to Green to come on in a few minutes. And following them will be USO Red with Shostakovich 8-string quartet, also titled his Kammer Symphony, Chamber Symphony, arranged by Rudolf Barshai. Very powerful work, an extremely affecting work. It is dedicated to all of the victims of fascism, but it's very clear that he was thinking of Stalinist and Nazi forces in World War II. As someone who comes from a family of multiple Holocaust survivors, it's a very important piece to me, and I think it speaks with as much power and relevance and poignance today as it has at any time in its history. It begins very quietly, it ends very quietly, but you will hear the whole range of the human experience depicted in this work. Emotional range, but also the savagery and brutal nature that we all have somewhere inside, whether we admit it or not. But there are also moments of astonishing beauty that reminds us all of that quintessentially human experience and trait, in that from even the most desperate of circumstances, humanity has often been able to create great moments of beauty. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is our third and final act and our final performance of the spring semester. We wish everyone a fantastic summer vacation. As always, we have a few thank yous. For everyone who has been supportive of these fantastic young artists and young musicians on stage, whether it's teachers, parents, and particularly the applied instructors at Texas Tech University, please join me in thanking all of them now. Our mantra, as I said, this for the last more than a year now, has been to find opportunities for personal, artistic, and musical growth within our collective challenges. And in so doing, also try to do that in the most positive and supportive atmosphere possible. I'm so proud of what we have seen happen with our students this year. The amount of artistic growth and individual growth, it's a trajectory that's just truly astonishing. I count myself very blessed to have been a part of it. We also have a few special thank yous today. In just a few moments, we're going to do the world premiere of the full string orchestra version of DJ Spar's concerto for vibraphone. Now, DJ is actually here with us this week, and it's always a thrill to work with someone of his caliber, but I think particularly I should mention that DJ is a former member of the Texas Tech School of Music's composition faculty and is the husband of our former professor of viola, Kimberly Spar. So please join me in welcoming back, a very warm welcome back to Lubbock, DJ Spar. Again, we had the wonderful collaboration of Charles Olivier on our tangos, and he's not able to be with us at this end of the program because he has another conflicting engagement. But please, for our wonderful audience watching from home, please thank him once again for that fantastic work he did with USO Glean. Now, finally, before I recognize one special person, I'd like to thank the recording services of the School of Music, particularly under the direction of Professor of Music, Composition, and Media, Hideki Izoda, for just making all of this possible. They are recording at three separate locations simultaneously today, and it's quite an impressive operation. It allows us to do what we're doing today on stage, and it allows this we have on stage to reach you at home. So for all of Professor Izoda's troops, partners in crime, and collaborators, thank you to the recording services. Now, in just a moment, Ensemble Bravura Yellow will join me on stage, but I will be joined by Professor of Percussion, Lisa Rogers. She has been an absolute delight and pleasure to collaborate with it in this process. And I want to mention, it's very difficult to talk with a mask on. Apparently, the word collaborate is particularly hard to say. This work that you're about to hear is not only going to be premiered by Professor Rogers, but it was commissioned and dedicated to Lisa Rogers. So this is very much a family affair here, and I think the collaboration between DJ and Lisa has been an exquisitely wonderful thing to behold. Our rehearsals have just been full of creativity, and almost as if the music is being written in real time as we have discovered the kind of unique sound world and the potential color palettes of a concerto for vibraphone. For those of you listening at home, we've actually put up some recent examples of fantastic vibraphone playing in history, and we'll see if we can forward some of those from the orchestral studies listserv. But this is an opportunity to hear vibraphone outside of what its historical context might have been. We think of some of the great jazz artists of our time, or perhaps occasionally you'll see them on stage in an orchestra in something like a Bernstein chart. But here, it inhabits kind of a dual personality. DJ has done a wonderful job in really recognizing the sonic and tonal properties and capabilities of it, not just its idiomatic and kind of classic sounds, but discovering new sounds that I'm not going to tip you off on right now, but as you listen carefully, you're going to find some interesting new sounds that have been created. And while it does have one foot in kind of the jazz background, that's not what we're going to hear today. We're going to hear an equal instrument along with the strings that weaves back and forth inside and out of the texture. At one moment, a solo voice. At another moment, an equal voice with the strings. And all of these different parts in between, as it were, we'll find that from one bar to the next bar,
we discover all kinds of new color and sonic properties. It's been an absolute delight, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
final selection is a timeless melody, sometimes attributed to Corelli, sometimes to Giannetti, sometimes to others, but it's simply known as La Follia, simply in English, madness.